I use two packets.
Yeah.
Like you said, I like to make more, so I'll have for lunch and I know what these are.
This is a sparkling
Alright. So I don't want to take too much of your all's time. What I'd like you to do now is check out pages 8 and 9, which are suggestions for maybe help you your choices. Resources when you're planning your meals throughout this next week. And then what I would like you to do is on page 2, there's a little diagram of my plate, and I want you to think about a meal that you eat frequently and try to modify it by filling out all the little sections of the plate. How can you make your meal better using this tool?
What milk could you alter to fit that in?
They say we've done that for 60 years. Who the fastest is going to go today? Part of the reason I say that is what I said before, if we're eating
Friday food or make more Friday nutrients. But I know that's hard in shops. You have to pan, prep your meal, cook it. It's easy sometimes to use.
There's two of them.
Maybe.
Yep.
Well, you could go with one of those ways to do that, some kind of salad, your dressing on the side, and just be cautious about.
Right.
Sometimes now, I do have a section where it says, help your options. I would like those.
Thank you.
Have you ever been to Care Cafe?
Just by itself.
That is, just by that Sheen's on Wood Bridge that goes to Randall. It's kind of tucked away behind that Sheen's, but they do. Yeah.
I found the healthy option, which I was kind of glad of, because after I did it, then I had to go searching. The Arby's, the small Jimmers roast beef, really are kind of good, not too bad, with nothing on them. And then the other thing is, I didn't find one of the sliders, but I just, it was a chicken slider, but I took the, I didn't eat the bun. Just ate the chicken, and it was, they're small also. So when I got the calories on the Arby's, Junior, with no sauce or anything on them, that wasn't too bad.
Okay, I'm gonna use that then. I'm gonna cook the beef.
Two tablespoons of 60 calories and 5 grams of chicken.
And the bun in the greens. And then how could you round that out with your fruit and vegetable and dairy?
If you go out.
Now, maybe, you couldn't buy it there at Arby's, maybe you would have to bring something with you, or.
And send extra virgin olive.
You know, I don't want that for a reason.
She said there was extra fruit.
Favorite fruit?
Not my what extra virgin.
How much fat was there?
Yeah.
I was like, oh, my God, I can't eat it. Just like KFC. I don't eat KFC.
Then I would tell you that the rest of your day, you should have whole grains. Is that fun? It's not really whole grains. Does anybody have any questions before we talk about your to-do list?
Why does nobody serve a whole grain bun? Think about that.
They're starting to. They're starting to. You know, maybe, I don't know what McDonald's does, but we went to Subway and they had whole grains.
I always call it bread.
Yeah.
Always.
So, this is your to-do list for next week. I would ask you to read over page 10 while you're away from us. There's a lot of food info there. Ask your health coach questions you may have. So, we want you to keep tracking your weight. You have a scale at home. Keep tracking what you're eating. Try to do something active 3 to 4 days next week, or you know, pick something that works for you. Make it personal to your own goals and lifestyle.
Say that again.
We're going to try to be active 3 to 4 days this week. Whatever works for you. We want you to try something you like doing. It's not supposed to feel like a punishment. It's supposed to be fun and make you feel good. So brisk walking, or if you can't do that, maybe you want to sit down and stretch. Try some different stretches. Yeah. Doesn't have to be strenuous. Just try to get 3 to 4 days. Also, take your plate there, and you might notice when you go home that the plate a little smaller than the ones you have at home, because over time our plates have become bigger. And just visually, when you put a, you know, an appropriate portion on a big plate, it looks like pitiful. So you pile it up on the plate to make it look like a good meal. Some people have researched this and they find that you use a smaller plate, you eat less, but you still feel satisfied. It might take a while to, you know, adjust to that, but give it a try. Use the My Plate as a model for a meal this week. And think about these questions. Did you make any changes to better match the My Plate model? And if yes, what were they? And next week, we're going to start talking about the physical activity goal.
Next week, a few housekeeping. Next week, we will be back to our normal time. Today was the only day we had to move half hour later because there was a event going on in this church. Also, I have received here blood results. There's two of you who need to go and give the blood, and we will catch those two to make sure that we have their blood work done. But I have the results of all of you. I have personally not reviewed it. It has come in. So I want to sit with each one of you next week and give me 10 minutes so we can go over your results, talk about your baseline. And the week after next, I will be in Chicago. So when I'm looking at the number and when I'm adding 10 minutes, so it's taking a lot of time. So I'm requesting you to come, and this is what I want to discuss. If it was more than town, I would have more options. But here, since I come only one day, so I can start at 1 o'clock and fit about 9 people before we get started. You can still come and get weighed. But those of you who will, let's say, come at 1 o'clock, you can come in, do your consult, get your weight done. You can go back and come at the regular 2:30 time for the session. But if you're closer to the session, you might just stay back. So I can fit 9 people before, and I can fit the rest after, or I can even come earlier, meaning I can start at 9 o'clock from Morgantown and be here by noon and get more people in before. What would you prefer? Or would you prefer to do a phone consult? So I don't want to wait for another 3 weeks for some to get it, because next week and then the week after that I'm gone, you know, for a conference. What would you prefer? Would you prefer a phone consult? Is it okay for you to come, you know, before and then get the consult, go back and come? Would you prefer that? So if I start at noon, will that be okay for some of you?
A phone consult would work just fine for me, and then okay. That would help you with your schedule too. You
know? No, I'm willing to do anything that you want. I personally prefer a face-to-face.
Okay.
But if a phone will work for you, I can do that. Because I don't want people to be waiting too long after the sessions. I would rather you come. And I don't want her to come, for example, and wait. So I would rather Jenna come closer to the session time. So that, because she has 45 minutes of drive. So I don't want that. So other people, I can fit it into my schedule. I can come.
We could be here about 1:30 to 2 of us.
Okay, 1:30. Okay, already.
Church to 12.
Okay, so if I start at 12:30, will that be? Because we want to sign up people today.
I think that would be
fine.
Okay. I don't mind coming up.
12:30? Okay. 12:30, 12:40. Steve and Barbara. Who wants to go at 12:50? 12:51? Yes. 1 o'clock. 1:10? 1:10. 1:10.
Why don't you just have them
come over? No, I'm just asking. 1:20? 1:20. 1:30?
Okay.
1:30.
Yeah, and then he's next.
1:30, 1:40,
1:50.
Okay.
This is next week.
Next week.
2?
2:10?
I can do
10. Okay, 2:10. So 2:20.
Fine.
Okay. So we have.